Okay, Erin, we're looking at these bats, and to me they look a little bit like mice. Are they connected to rodents at all?
Actually, no, they're not. That's actually a very common misconception that bats are basically rats with wings or right. mice with wings. But that's actually not true at all. They're most closely related to the branch in the evolutionary tree that has whales and dogs and cats and bears. They're in carnivora. They're a carnivore. Actually, the closest branch to rodents on the tree is actually primates, like you and
no
me.
No way.
We're actually closely related to rodents than bats are.
That's saying something. I did not know that. Yeah. Interesting. Okay, they look a little bit more like mice than we do. Maybe that's why people think that often.
Yeah, that's probably why, yeah.
Okay, and is this, that's the skull?
This is the skull, yeah.
My
it's
gosh.
Pretty delicate, but
it
if you look
tiny.
At it, they've got a bunch of little needly teeth, just
yeah.
like a cat would.
Oh, okay, all so what them, is their diet made up of?
Flying insects, so not just mosquitoes, but also moths. I mean, they'll go mm-hmm. after anything that flies if it's active at night.
So they're helpful yeah. for the environment
yeah,
and for humans.
They're definitely very beneficial to us. They reduce crop damage due to insects.
So are these all different species of bat, the different sizes?
Yes, yeah, so I tried to pick kind of some representatives from each sort of group of bats in Ohio.
This
I mean,
one
these
looks
are all
like a traditional kind of classic bat
right.
that you would think of.
Yeah, this is a big brown bat. Like if you have bats in your attic, this is probably one of the two species that might be in there.
Okay.
The other species would be the little brown bat, and I've got them here. So this is the little brown
little
and this
brown.
Is the big brown, and there's
oh.
actually not that much of a difference
really
in size.
Isn't. So what are these fuzzy little guys?
Okay, this little guy here is the aptly named red bat, and also native to Ohio. And this guy up here is what's now known as the tri-colored bat. In
okay.
the past it was called the eastern pipistrelle, and it's one of the smallest bats in the United States.
So what's this bigger guy?
That's an eastern hoary bat.
Ooh.
And so named for the pattern of his fur.
Yeah, he's got an interesting pattern. So a lot of these bats, these are mostly eating insects, flying
yeah.
insects.
Mm-hmm.
So they're not feasting on anything else. They're not eating
human
any
blood,
other,
for example.
Human blood or any animals or anything
no,
like that.
No, bats are associated with vampires
they
and
are.
Blood drinking.
Uh-huh.
And there's actually only three species of bats in the world that feed on blood.
Huh.
Two of them specialize on birds. And the third specializes on mammals, but it very rarely targets humans.
That's how they got that reputation. They
You hear something outrageous, and it's, well, this is like what happens with the internet now. You
right.
hear something outrageous.
It spreads. Speaking of pop culture myths, I feel like I've been told that bats are blind. There's the blind as a bat phrase. Is
right.
that remotely true?
No, not at all.
Huh.
There are bats that have relatively poor eyesight, but they can all see. As probably most people know, their main sense is hearing, because they use echolocation as to form a 3D picture of their surroundings
cool.
using sound.
So they have really good hearing and they have sufficient
Pretty
vision.
Sufficient, yeah.
Okay, so it should be like moderately well-sighted as a bat, not blind as a bat.
That's
maybe.
Right, yeah.
So where do most of these bats live? Are they in caves? Are they in your attic?
Well, there's here in Ohio, there's two kinds of bats. There's bats that will use caves to hibernate in during the winter, and then there's bats that actually migrate and go further south and roost in trees in more mild climates. But the big brown and little brown bats are both cave roosters, and they've actually been pretty severely impacted by what's called white nose syndrome.
Oh, what does it cause?
In the wintertime, the fungus will thrive and it'll grow on their wings and their faces, hence the name white nose
mm-hmm.
syndrome. What happens is it causes them to wake up more, start flying around, and they'll use up all of their fat reserves and ultimately die
oh,
to exposure.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
Is there a way to avoid it, or are humans doing anything to kind of help
we
the
are.
Bat pocket?
Wow. It's just a question of how do we treat all the bats
right.
in North America when we can't? How are we going to manage this? We can also wait and hope that they
yeah.
develop a natural immunity, which is what the European bats have done. I would also encourage people to provide bat houses or an alternative for them because
That's
they
a good
are
idea.
They are desperately in need of our help.
Do you have any advice for someone if they come across a bat, if they find an injured bat, or they a bat gets into their home and is flying around? How do you address that?
The first piece of advice I would give is don't try to handle it.
Okay, fair enough.
They will definitely bite if handled.
Okay.
So step one, don't pick it up.
Gotcha.
If you can isolate it in a room and mm-hmm. open a window, eventually the bat will find its way out.
Okay.
You just have to wait. And a lot of people who have bats in their attics get professional help, and they
mm-hmm.
do it in a way that's not harmful to the bats.
Okay.
It just encourages them to find another
mm-hmm.
another Scoot place
on
to
out.
Go.
Yeah. Cool. Well, thank you so much for telling us about this and educating us.
Yeah, happy to.